You know, when you're pregnant, everybody seems to think that you have to wear tents. Like, you have to all of a sudden lose all of your sense of style, your sense of wanting to look nice. When Rihanna was pregnant, she came out and she bossed it, and there was look after look. And actually, I'm not gonna have any more kids, but it made me think, I wish I was pregnant at the same time she was, because she would have given me a bit of an inspire, made me think, actually, why not? Hey, it's Rochelle, and I'm about to answer Grazia's 10 hot questions. First up, who'd play you in a movie of your life? I think, mainly because I girl crush her, Zendaya. Love her, she is amazing. And yeah, I mean, she probably wouldn't want to take that job, but I'd ask her. Next question. If you had to pick a reality show to be on, what would it be? I think, purely so I could be a fly on the wall, I would like to be on The Real Housewives of Beverly Hills, because it's just brilliant. I just want to have a look around their homes. I just want to have a seat at the table when the drama's going down, purely just to watch. I don't need to say anything. I'll just be like, where's Wally in the background, just there. What has been the most embarrassing moment of your career? How long you got? A standout for me, I did like a charity special of Bake Off, which is one of my favorite shows. We all watch it, we love it. And I was really quite smug after the first bake because I got the best feedback and I was like secretly buzzing. And then in the mystery bake, everything was in the oven. I was looking around, it looked good. You know, they looked perfect, I might add. And then I tasted a bit of the edge when I pulled them out and it was really salty. And I realized that because everything's in glass pots, I put salt in instead of sugar. So yeah, nearly poisoned Mary Berry, but she's still okay. She's still okay. That was probably the most embarrassing thing. My daughter often looks at that on YouTube, which is great. What's your worst habit? That's an easy one. If you called my husband, he would agree. I'm the most impatient human in the world. I want everything done yesterday. I'm a bit of a perfectionist too. So yeah, that I know they are my worst qualities, but do you know what? Sometimes they work for me. Who was your first celebrity crush? All of Take That. Love them. I would have had any one of them. I just remember being like, oh my goodness, it's a boy band and they're amazing. There was a video that they had like jelly. Do you remember that? Was that iconic or is that just me that remembers it? They like rubbed like jelly all over them and I was like, they're amazing. And my mum was like, you can't watch that. What's something that winds you up on Instagram? Quite a lot. But I think the most annoying thing for me on Instagram is, you know, when you're sort of scrolling through and it might be like early in the morning, and you don't want to wake up the other person in the room and you accidentally hit unmute on a reel and then it just screams at you and you're like, no. They've changed something recently that didn't happen before. You could just open it and see it big. Now you have to hear it at max volume. Yeah, as you can tell, that really annoys me. What's a fashion rule that you totally disagree with? Do you know what I would say? You know, when you're pregnant, everybody seems to think that you have to wear tents. Like, you have to all of a sudden lose all of your sense of style, your sense of wanting to look nice, and you sort of dress like, I'm not sure where you're from, some sort of old commute. I don't know what this is, but this is weird style of dressing. And do you know what I loved? When Rihanna was pregnant, she came out and she bossed it, and there was look after look. And actually, I'm not gonna have any more kids, but it made me think, I wish I was pregnant at the same time she was, because she would have given me a bit of an inspire, made me think, actually, why not? Who, living or dead, is your style icon? My goodness, I love so many women. But I would say Zoe Kravitz, for me, is just the best dressed woman. And I think not just in terms of her clothes and her outfits, but her glam. I always sort of look to her for like red carpet references. I think she is just phenomenal. What's the one song guaranteed to get you on the dance floor? In brackets, sing it. Guys, that's mean, but I will. My favorite song, and probably literally all of my friends reply to every story going, really, again? And that is Coffee and Toast. If I hear that song, as soon as I hear, blessings are for me, life and... That's me. Even the first bit, dum, 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 dum. Go on with it, go on with it. I'm there, I'm yours. And do you know what? Try and stop me. I think it's more the point of get her off the dance floor. She's done too much. My favorite red carpet moment actually was probably really recent. I went to Cannes Film Festival with L'Oreal And from the minute I got there, I felt like a princess. It was absolutely incredible. I stayed away for 2 nights, kid-free, which was magic. From start to finish, it was honestly just like a movie. I just remember looking down the carpet and thinking, oh my goodness, I'm stood here with all of these other L'Oreal ambassadors that I've like grown up watching on the adverts. Like, Eva Longoria was next to me, and then Viola Davis, and so on and so forth, thinking, my goodness, I'm here. I don't know how I'm here, but we're just going to go with it. So yeah, that was definitely my favourite red carpet moment. So there you go. That's it. Thank you very much, Grazia, for having me. That's been your 10 hot questions.